kani kadege batisi tv mat pidang pek yeki khubor ba mankasni blawan rasha phi da orange nissan loom so pho ne fabricate shillong ringkat bat ka eco friendly enterprise ki plakot nagamanta ki jingdon kam hakasong bat kara karong
naki arpot li karkhana sang deuyong ki badan hakashnong shalang ka committee on environment joga yingdor ba thau an ke jilla haka laipui tarik unai tung arjar arpho kala pente bon sha satang nyautli bakin trikam hadien bakila pen biang yiki kot isla shwa ban chemi ni rai ni committee kala khot hajeri kitna trikam ba fer fer jong ka sorka jilla ki bakin thop eka meghalaya state pollution control board bat ki wik wei ban panjing pichai halor ka rukam trikam jingini karkhana u chairman jong ka committee ba eski sun haka jingi kran bakila pathai kubor ulai thu ba kanika committee hakani ka singi kraya thirsani ru halor ka draft jong ka environment impact assessment bat ka jingpun to chakhlia jong ki hospital gi banana ka jilla shaki nala bat ki wa
five number of agendas. The number one is about the fuel alloy making unit at Bunyan. The number one B is the setting up of coal industrial units at Shalang, and then number two is the pollution caused by the Star Cement and also by the Jaitia Cement. Number three is about the environmental impact assessment draft 2020, and then number four is about the disposal of hospital waste pre-COVID-19 situation and during COVID-19 situation. And number five is the planning of this for expansion of road along Shillong Peak, which has affected the drinking water sources at the slope of Shillong Peak that it has supplied to the upper Shillong.
Relating to the Shakambari ferroalloys first, which is located in Ruyam near Phnom Stoin. There has been a press briefing relating to the smoke that is being emitted and the pollution caused by this particular ferroalloys factory, causing health hazard in the vicinity and the villages around. We had summoned the officials concerned, including the Deputy Commissioner of West Carthage. And it was reported to us that this particular factory had been given single window clearance in 2011. And it got its clearance from the State Pollution Board in 2015. And since then, this factory has been operational. But sadly, the State Pollution Board could not give us a clear picture as to how many inspections it had conducted. But the last inspection that they did was recently, maybe about 10 days back, when this committee had written to the State Pollution Board to submit a report, an inspection report. The inspection report gave us a very bleak picture about the factory because of the COVID situation, the factory is closed. That was kind of a report. But what we found out from other sources is that this factory is using charcoal. A lot of charcoal is being used to run the factory. And this question was placed to the mining officer, and he said that there are challans that have been submitted, and apparently charcoal is being purchased all the way from Andhra Pradesh. That is what the reply was given to us. We have asked the concerned departments to submit all the papers and documents to the committee. So we will be getting the details about the challans of how the coal has been brought and in what quantity the coal has been brought all the way from Andhra Pradesh to operate this particular factory. There was also a suggestion made by the chairman relating to zoning atlas, which would have been very, very essential, would have been very beneficial also to detect and to find out and regulate the establishment and the setting up of factories, both legal and illegal, throughout the state. And this committee has recommended to the government that, and to the Forest Department, of course, the Principal Secretary Forest has assured that he will examine and look into it whether this particular facility of zoning atlas could be set up in the state, which will facilitate and benefit the Department of Forest, Department of Mining, and the Department of State Pollution Board and Industries as well. Also discussed on the mushrooming of oak factory in the West Khasi Hills. It was reported to us that in it started from 2018, August, the Industries Department has started giving clearance of setting up of these coke factories in West Khasi Hills. And within 2 years' time, they have already given single window clearance for about 16 of them. 16 coke factories have been given single window clearance to set up coke factory. And out of which, I think 7 coke factories are already operational and they are already functioning. This committee reviewed the whole matter very seriously. Why? Because as we all know that the mushrooming of the coke factory has caused a lot of health hazard in the whole Shalam belt area. And so suddenly, then within a span of about 6 to 8 months, we noticed that there have been so many coke factories that have been established. As per the reports given, there are 8 factories who have already set up factories illegally without any permission. This is as per the report of the Deputy Commissioner Monstoin. So this committee has directed the authorities concerned not to allow opening or operating of these 8 factories any longer. These 8 factories, the owners did not even turn up for the inquiry that was conducted by the Additional Deputy Commissioner Monstoin. Thereby, they proved that they are all illegal and they wanted to run the factory without any documents or without any papers. The committee has finally decided that the department's concern should allow a setting up of only 7 coke factories who have furnished their documents and also got the certificate to operate from the State Pollution Board.
One is red, one is orange, one is green, and one is white, depending on their pollution potential of the industries. Coke factory falls under the red category. So setting up of any industrial unit under the red category required to apply for the consent to establish, we call it CPE, from the Pollution Control Board. After they get the consent to establish, then they can go ahead for the civil construction, then other infrastructure. After they have finished that, they will apply for consent to operate. The officer from the Pollution Control Board will go and inspect the infrastructure created by them, then the other pollution control measures, control devices put up by them, and after they are satisfied with that, they give the consent to operate. And that consent to operate is valid only for 3 months. After 3 months, the Pollution Control Board again deputed officials to go and inspect and then collect samples for waste, air, water, and to analyze in their laboratory if their waste collected by them is within their permissible limit. If it is within the permissible limit, they were allowed to continue to operate. But if it is above the permissible limit, then the plant will have to take a shutdown. And the consent to operate will be revoked. So in this aspect, as what Bashantian has stated, there are a number of 20 plus coke industrial units set up in Shalanti. Out of that, three has got the consent to establish as well as the consent to operate, and they were in operation. And remaining numbers are in different stages of getting the consent to establish. Out of that, only four numbers have got the consent to establish, and we will be allowed to go ahead with the civil construction. So like he said, altogether, out of these 20 plus, it will only 7. So this is the position now. We have taken a stand as a committee. We'll go ahead with the suggestion given by the district administration of West Casinos. 3 in operation will be allowed to continue. 4 will have got the consent to establish, will be allowed to go ahead with the construction, subjected to inspection by the board before giving them the consent to operate, and the remaining will not be allowed to sell.
All these industries in West Casinos, it will inspect the ferro alloys, Shakambari ferro alloys at Ruyang. It will also conduct an inspection of all the coke industries that are flourishing in the West Kasin region. And the date of the inspection has been fixed on the 18th of August 2020. So this committee would visit West Kasin and conduct spot inspection. Further, this committee also examined the air pollution caused by the cement factories in the JT Hills region. There was a video that was circulated by one gentleman, Lam Chan. So he had circulated an event viral relating to the smoke emitted from the Star Cement factory. Therefore, this was discussed, and the State Pollution Board has given the justification for the smoke emission. He said that the reason is because this factory has been closed for quite a long time during this lockdown period, and therefore when you restart the furnace and restart the engines, at that point of time there is a tendency of smoke being emitted at a higher level, and therefore that was the reason given. And similarly, there was also another complaint for smoke being emitted from JTS Cements. JTS Cement at Nathur Cape. This was a complaint lodged by the brother of the Honorable MP, and he had sent it viral also, and then was caught on the viral. Then he had also requested that this matter may be discussed. So when we examined through the State Pollution Board, State Pollution Board explained to us that the machines in JT Cement are pretty old, and they are not the machines of the day. And therefore, the committee suggested that the State Pollution Board and the Central Pollution Board together would visit and examine the industry, JT Cement, and suggest to them the measures to be taken up to improve the emission of the smoke from the factory, so that it does not hamper or create any higher hazard in the village and in the vicinity. We also discussed the EIA draft of 2020, which was placed, and I think Government of India has given an extended time till the 11th of August for every state government or any organization to give their views and comments. And the Principal Secretary Forrest had explained that they are going to have a discussion very soon at the government level to
take a
stand as to which are the issues for them to be taken up. From the committee, we also expressed one or two issues, and that was that the government should also suggest that the six scheduled area are to be also given considerable avenues within the draft, so that certain the regulations and all are not confined much to these six scheduled areas. There was also suggestion that the minor minerals within the state should also be given a considerable considered view, because many of our rural area people depend on the sand mining, they depend on the extraction of minor minerals, and that is because of their livelihood.
In respect of this EIA, Environmental Impact Assessment, one of the main contentious issues that really bother every one of us is that the draft 2020 reduced the public consultation period from the present 45 days to 20 days. Present actually the 2006 gave the public consultation for any project to be set up for 45 days. But this new draft reduced the public consultation period from 45 days to only 20 days. And there are certain projects that need not consult the public. So this is a very contentious issue that we have requested the government of the day to take a call, take a stand, and put up a suggestion to the Ministry of the Environment, Forest and Climate Change for taking these issues into consideration.
The illegal felling of trees in Sangmin area,
Shillong Peak,
on the way to Shillong Peak. So there was this PWP road is being widened towards the Redcourt Peak, and therefore in the process the PWP had cut down about 12 trees without the permission of the Forest Department. Our honourable member from Umroy, Bartosz Lindowa, had given a suggestion that in future such forests which are very close to the town and which are very good habitat for birds and for catchment areas should be protected, and therefore he has also appeal to the Forest Department to come up with proposals or policy wherein such forests should be declared as protected, just not the Upper Shillong or the Shillong Peak Forest, but other such forests throughout the state should also be protected. And this was unanimously accepted and agreed by the committee, and we have resolved today that the government should explore possibilities of creating more such forests as protected and declaring more forests as protected, and a policy should be drawn up wherein schemes should be provided for to the Forest Department to keep up these such forests to remain green and also to protect the catchment areas.
The new draft Environment Impact Assessment 2020, which was having a last date on June 30th, but the Delhi High Court has extended it up to 11th of August, has tried to dilute the public consultation by reducing the period of public consultation from 45 days as per the 2006 EIA to or just 20 days only. Apart from that, there are projects which need not require public consultations. that which really, you know, very, very important for us to ensure that the department take up this issue with the government in Delhi. That public consultation is a must for any project we set up here in the state of Meghalaya, and that public consultation period should not be reduced from 45 days to just 20 days. These are the two issues actually which really require to be discussed, which is required to be taken up with the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change at Delhi.